Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves, and he was transfigured before them. And his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fire on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. And Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He hardly knew what to say, they were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." So when looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Keeping on my theme for the year of prayer, the Transfiguration is a wonderful example of what prayer is about. What happens at the Transfiguration, and what do we expect from prayer? What we expect from prayer is usually a good starting point for understanding this. Most people go into prayer with a laundry list. Most people treat prayer like it's a genie bottle, where you go in there, you say three Hail Marys, like rubbing the genie bottle three times, and suddenly it's supposed to work out the way you want it to. And what it really comes off to us many times is, this is a really bad genie bottle. Because no matter how many times we seem to throw a Hail Mary at it, rub the genie bottle, God doesn't seem to do what I want. That's not how prayer works. That's not what prayer is meant to be. Prayer isn't meant to be us sitting in with this long list of, "Lord, I want this, Lord, I want that, Lord, I want this." The Transfiguration is a lot more what prayer is meant to be like. Going to be alone with the Lord. Peter, James, and John went up the high mountain apart by themselves with Jesus to go and be alone with God. Why? So he can reveal himself to you. What happened at the Transfiguration? Christ gave them not a full view, but just a glimpse of who he is in his fullness. This is what prayer is supposed to be. When we go and spend time saying, "Lord, help me understand you. Lord, I've got all these worries. Here are my worries." Yes, it's good for me to bring my worries to you. "Here are my worries. Let's start off by getting those out of the way. And now, for the rest of my prayer time, Lord, help me understand you. How do you fit into my life? And how do I fit into yours? Lord, help me see you as you really are." Everybody says you're all loving who say that they know you. Help me see it. In all honesty, I try not to talk about the media too much because I'll get just plain downright frustrated with all of them. I don't care which media you watch. But it sincerely bothered me when I heard about somebody, and I don't even remember, I know who it was, but I don't even know how to pronounce the name right. But saying When you talk to God, that's normal, but when you hear God talk to you, that's a mental disorder. When you're talking to God in prayer, that's good. When you're hearing God speak back to you, then you're doing it right. If you never hear God speaking to you, then there is something wrong with how you are praying. If you think God isn't supposed to speak to you, you do not understand the Catholic Christian faith. We are supposed to hear Him speaking to us. He is supposed to be revealing Himself to us every time we go into prayer. Now, it may not be a loud, booming voice. This is God. That might be an issue. But He does speak. He tells me jokes. I say to Him, Lord, please, I'll do whatever you ask of me. I really don't want to deal with any situation like this situation I just dealt with. Next week, the same situation pops up, and I look at him and go, yeah, funny. Lord, I really could just use a peaceful week. I look at my calendar, and then I look at him and go, funny again. I talk to somebody about a situation, and while I'm talking to them, I'm actually hearing God speaking to them, telling them what they need to hear, and it's the exact same thing I need to be hearing at this moment in my life. And I look at God and go, I get it. I get it. You're a comedian. God is speaking to us, revealing Himself to us every time we pray. If you don't hear God, something is wrong. Sometimes it has to do with your moral life. Sometimes it has to do with how you're praying. Sometimes it has to do with the ability to just have silence in the midst of the world. Sometimes we need to be like Peter, James, and John and go away. Go on retreat. Get away from life. Or even, it doesn't say that they were there that long. Maybe it was a single day. Maybe it was just a few hours. To get away and spend time with God and say, God, speak to me. Your servant is listening. Lord, speak to me. Tell me your will for me, and I will follow. Prayer is not about us changing God. Though there are things He will give us if we ask that He wasn't going to give us if we didn't ask. Much the way a loving father and mother works at home. But it's more about us being transformed ourselves. To know who God is and to hear Him calling us to be more and more like Him. That is what the name Christian means. Christ-like. How is God calling you in your prayer to be more like Christ today?